Good afternoon, guys. This video presentation is a continuation with my previous vessel, previous video, and this time I'm going to use a loadicator. But the loadicator I'm going to use is for capsized vessel, because I don't have the loadicator for MV Nara. But anyway, I will just show you the procedures on how to use the loadicator for those who haven't used any loadicator on board. So let's start, guys. Okay. So this is the problem that we have last time, last video, and we have the ROV or departure in shuttle, and this is the ROV arrival in Isabel. So we're going to load 21068, okay, metric tons. So I have here, I will show the loadicator. This is a capsized vessel of loadicator. First and foremost, we click the initial, and here I already put here Seattle Washington to Isabel Leyte. Okay, so you put this at sea because you're going to depart at Seattle, and you put the density or specific gravity of water in seawater, which is 1.012, which is this one, guys, 1.012. okay, and we will have a different displacement because this is I'm using a capsized vessel. Okay, so we go to the cargo. So I put here number 2, SG is tons per cubic meter, sis factor is cubic feet per long ton. So we will concentrate on SG, guys. So I have here our cargo is a fertilizer. Okay, I'll show you to confirm. So to load fertilizer in Seattle, Washington. Okay, so we will get the specific gravity of the fertilizer. So fertilizer storage factor, for example, urea fertilizer storage factor of approximately 1 to 1.2 cubic meter per metric tons. Okay, so 1 to 1.2, while ammonium nitrate fertilizer has a storage factor of 1.1 to 1.3. okay, so we'll just use this one, guys, the urea fertilizer. So we go to, so I put here 1.2, and number 4 1.2, number 6 1.2, and number 8 1.2. okay, so its storage factor here will be 39.9 cubic feet per long ton, and number 4 will be 29.901 cubic feet per long ton. So it's the same. Okay, so we go now to the fuel oil. According to the fuel oil, this will be departure shuttle. Okay, according to the plan, departure, according to the departure in shuttle FO is 10.10.10.31. Okay, so we go to there. 10.31. Okay. Yes. 10.30 divide 2. That will be 15.15. Look here. 5.15. The other one. 516. This is compute. You put save and save again. Yes. So that will be 10.31. Okay. Excuse me. 10.31. And DO is 37. Okay. DO is 37. We go to diesel oil. 36 divided 2. That will be 18 and 19. Or 18. So 19, save that one. So 18 plus 19 is 37. Okay, so DO is 37 and lube oil is 18. So this guy's, there's no lube oil, so I just put here 18 as lube oil. Okay, a total of 55. Then after lube oil, we have fresh water. Fresh water of 4 excuse me, 454. 454 by 2. That will be 227. Go to fresh water. Fresh water. This one. 227. And there. Then 228. That will be 455. Okay. Save this one. Save and delete. So okay. So what else? We have fresh water. Constant guys will be different because the constant here of a capsized vessel is different. Let's say here constant. This constant here is 380 because this is a vessel, capsized vessel, so his constant is 380. Okay, not unlike in Embinara, his constant is 185. Okay, so bear with me. And the total cargo, the total cargo is 21068. Okay. Total cargo is 21068. Instead of putting the cargo in 1 and 4, I put it to holds 4 and 6. And The total cargo will be 2168. Look guys, this is the most that I can do. The deflection is 15 centimeters, meaning 1 centimeter, 1.5 centimeters. Hug. Why hug? Because in a capsized vessel, the forward and up part of the vessel is too heavy. Especially in the up because of the machineries and other equipments. And forward is the windlass and other stores inside the forecastle. That's why it's too heavy in forward and up. So, usually if you're in ballast condition, it should be hugged. Usually hugged. To compensate the hug or take out the hug, you put the cargo in the middle. So, if you put the cargo here, this one will go up. Up will go up and this one will go down. So you will have a less hug, percentage in hug. So you will have, the most I can do is one centimeter, okay? And with this cargo, I have a trim of 3.31 and my mid drop is 4.48, okay? 4.48. Okay, and my density is 1.012. So this will be my departure drop. Forward, I have 2.83. It's a red because according to the year, the minimum forward drop should be 6.68, but I have 2.83. So that's why it's red. But anyway, if you use the load indicator for NARA, then the red will disappear. But look at the guys, the sharing force is good. Bending moment is normal and it's good. So this is the blue one. Blue one will be, I think, the sharing force. And the red is the bending moments. But it says good. And the percentage, look at the percentage, sharing force is 41.60 and bending moments is 53, still good, okay. And to show you the details, so this is the forward drop, mean drop, up drop, and the trim. The displacement is 49918. How much is the displacement here? Displacement is 29. See, 49 because it's a small ship, and we the capsize is bigger, so we have a displacement of 49918. And condition is at sea. When you depart, you put it at sea. And it's a GOM, no red. Immersion is only 23%, which is bad for capsize. It should be submerged under the water. But you have only 23%. Meaning, if I were using the lubricator for NARA, then the sinkage would be, or submersion would be 99% or 100%. Okay? And this is the specific gravity or density. All the rest, LCG and everything, okay? And if there's something wrong with the stability of the vessel, you will see red on these figures here, like this one. But so far, it's good. Airdrop, cargo, ballast. So we have, I said no ballast here. Fuel is 1031. Diesel is 5.5. Is that correct? 5.5 diesel. 5.5, yes, because of the including the lube oil. And the freshwater is 4.55. Okay. Check again. You add DO and lube oil is 4, 5, 5, 4, 5, 5, okay? So, let's go back. This is guys. Put this back. And here she is. And this is the graph. Look at the graph. It's good. This is your cargo. This is your ROV. Okay? So, then let's go to one thing good with the Loadicator. You can put your ROV so you can see the rough, the switch, the bending moments and the shearing force. And here upon arrival in Isabel, we will also put the ROV. Okay, so we go to Isabel. Fuel oil is 5.41. Okay, 5.41. We go to fuel oil. Go to fuel oil. So this is 4.31. We go to, now we go to arrival in Isabel. 5.41. 5.40. 5.40. 5.40 divided 2, that will be 270. 271. Okay, 5.41 guys. I want to save this first before it will not get lost. So fuel is arrival in Isabel is 5.41, okay? Check. So fuel is 5.41, okay? Then DO arrival is 19.5. Okay, 19.5. That's DO, okay? 19.5. We go to DO. 19.5. 18 divided 2. 9.10. It is 9.10. Save this one. So 19.5. So this should be, let's say put this to 9.5. Save. So 9.5 plus 10 equals 19.5. That will be your DO. And your lube oil is 18. Okay. So lube oil, I just put here 18 in the DO service tank to a total of 37.5. Okay. Then the next would be, you have already lube oil. Then we go to fresh water. Remaining fresh water is 350. Okay. You go to fresh water. 350 divided 2. That is 175. Excuse me. Put 175. Put here 175. Total of 350. Okay, just compute, then you save. So fresh water is 350. Then look at the still good here, and also the. But the deflection is getting bigger, so you have a 0. You have a 0 deflection, 0.02, 10, 0.02, okay, 2 divided 10, that will be 0.02. You have a 2 deflection, okay? 2 centimeters deflection. Okay. Because you have already consumed some weights. Then next will be so we have already the fresh water ballast is zero. Ballast is zero. Weight. Take note, guys. In a capsized vessel, you can never accomplish a zero ballast. There, at least the remaining unpumpable ballast is between. You can go as low as, I think, 70%, 70 metric tons, or 80 metric tons. But usually, it's average between 90 to 100. But you can never get a zero ballast in a capsized vessel. Okay? So, we go. So, that's it, guys. And what will be the condition upon arrival in Seattle? I'm sorry. What will be the condition arrival in Seattle? This will be the condition. The drop forward is 295. And we have a main drop of 442. Up drop of 589. We have a trim of 294. And we change the density. Change the density to 1.025. 1.025. Arrival density in Isabel. Compute that one. And save. And go to cargo. Go up. And your deflection is 0.02. 0.02 centimeters, and your propulsion immersion is 19%, which is not good for capsized. And your density is 0.25. I'm sorry, 0.25. Go back, 0.25. Okay. Calculate and save. You go to cargo, you can go to cargo. And your density is 1.025. Okay? And look at the graph, guys. It's still good. And the sharing force and bending moment is. Sharing force is 41.43% and bending moment is 48.69%. Don't go as far as 100% or 99.99. This one is safer. So, say here it's good. Normal sharing force bending moment is good. Allow mass each hold good. The allow mass to adjacent holds good. And allowable GOM good. So, okay, guys. We have red because of this one. And the visibility of 500 meters and the four drop should be minimum per drop should be 6.68. That's why you have a red because it's 2.91. Okay, otherwise the other factor is the same. Okay, so let's check, guys, the figures. So this is the ROB. Departure shuttle and ROB arrival in Leyte. Okay. And this is our maximum cargo to load is 21068, which is this one. 21068. Okay? And your, I'm sorry. This is the stress factor. This is the ROB. So, I just put this one down, guys. So, just open this one up. This is departure shuttle. See? Departure density is 1.012. Look at the graph, it's good. And the steering force and bending moments is also good. We have a no red here, so it's good. And your reflection is 1, almost 2 centimeters or 1, see, still very good. But your cargo is concentrated in hold number 4 and number 6 because this is a capsized. That's why I just show you how to put the fuel oil, diesel oil. Sorry. So I just show you how to put this fuel oil, diesel oil, lube oil, fresh water, and so on. Also with the arrival in Sabel. Okay? So, that's it, guys. I hope you got some points of what I'm trying to achieve. And if you like this video, please click the like button, share, and subscribe. Also, click the notification bell so you will be notified on every video that I make. Thanks a lot, guys, and have a good day.